Hi friends, in this video we'll discuss scope of practice in insurance sector. Now everybody is aware that because of the COVID-19 several things have happened. There are some unfortunate deaths which have happened because of COVID-19. Also the people have admitted themselves to hospitals for their medical treatments. So, because of all this, there are chances that there will be claims made by the people fundamentally in two segments. Number one, death claims. Number two, maturity claims. And number three, mediclaims. Now, maturity claims we'll deal subsequently. First, we will look to the death claims and mediclaim claims. Now, as you are aware that IRDA, that is Insurance Regulatory Development Authority of India, on 4th of March 2020 have issued certain guidelines because of which they have covered this particular COVID-19 disease into the policies which are taken by the people. That is a one page circular. If you go through that particular circular, you will find that it is not very specific. Yes, it says that their claims will be included, but how they will be dealt. For example, if somebody is going to file a death claim, do we really feel that in weeks time the claim will be processed? The answer, if yes, we are very happy, but if no, then there is chance of dispute. Because see, all the insurance companies are required to follow their norms, terms and conditions, compliances. Subsequent to that only the claim of death arising because of COVID-19 will be given in spite of IRDA circular of 4th of March 2020. Now, there are chances that disputes may arise in that claim. There are chances, we do not know, because after all the insurance companies will follow their norms. If they feel that the norm or the existing policy which the claimant had taken, whether it fits into that, whether it has hospitalization, whether it does not have hospitalization. So, there are chances that the disputes may arise in this particular segment. Identical thing may happen as far as the mediclaim is concerned, because mediclaim policy is now getting covered because of IRDA circular. But whether in actual the reimbursement will be given or not is a question we have to look in. A third thing which may creep in is the maturity claims. For example, let us take an example that a person has got his LIC policy matured and he has put the claim. Now, everybody is aware how the business situation has changed, how the economy has changed. We never know. The insurance company may tell that supposing your claim is of 100 rupees, because of this change situation, we will pay you in 3 installments, or we will pay you in 2 installments, or we may forfeit 10% of that. So, if for example, if I have 100 rupees of claim, either I may get 30, 30, 40, I may get 50, 50, or because of that policy of LIC I may get only 90. See, I will want to make clear that LIC means I am not crystallizing on a particular organization, but that's the word which has fit into our minds for insurance. Insurance companies, what I mean to say. So there are chances, because see, the people who are of aged, they will be dependent solely on their maturity. Now, if their maturity value gets deferred, there are bound to be disputes. So, friends, what I would like to suggest you is, insurance sector is one of that sector where the chances of disputes may happen between the claimants and the insurance company. So, in that process, people will certainly need our legal advisors, maybe by consultancy, maybe by issue of notices, maybe by filing litigation in the concerned authorities, maybe at ombudsman of IRDA or wherever the concerned litigation has to go. And this has arose only because of this lockdown issue. So, friends, these are some avenues we have tried to explore in our insurance sector. In our next video, we will discuss scope of practice in banking sector. Thank you.